Welcome to this online gathering at St Michael's Uniting Church in Melbourne. Wherever you are on your spiritual journey, wherever you've come from, wherever you're going to, whatever you believe, whatever you do not believe, you are welcome. We begin with an acknowledgement of country. The land on which St Michael stands is the sovereign and unceded country of the Wurundjeri people of the Kulin Nation. We pay our respects to their elders, past and present, who have cared for this country since its creation. And we commit ourselves to working for a more just sharing of resources and power between the First and Second Peoples of Australia. And I invite you to acknowledge the First People on whose land you live. In the season of Lent, we gather here to celebrate life's beauty and find healing for its pain, to honour our kinship with each other and with the earth, and to create a more compassionate world, beginning with ourselves. Welcome everyone, and a very warm welcome to anyone who is joining us for the first time. Greetings to St Michael's members who are participating online this Sunday. Online or in person, St Michael's is a community where faith is explored in an open and progressive way and expressed in spirituality that lifts up our hearts and in beautiful music that nourishes our souls. Today is the first Sunday in Lent. Lent is the 40-day season that began on Wednesday and concludes with Holy Week, with Palm Sunday, Maundy Thursday, Good Friday and Easter Sunday. It is a time of reflection, a time for pausing, for stillness. The word Lent comes from the same root as lengthen. In the Northern Hemisphere, it referred to the lengthening of days in spring. For Southern Hemisphere spirit seekers, the lengthening may be of the shadows of autumn, which is also a beautiful and appropriate image. Lent does not need to be about self-sacrifice or self-denial. The spiritual practices of Lent are intended to create a state of heart, being and spirit that is open to the divine and to our neighbours. Lent is a journey inward and a journey outward, inward to the heart and outward to the world. A hymn from the tradition of the church. Let us sing together, Guide Me, O My Great Redeemer. a prayer of awareness, opening us to the sacred within us, among us, and beyond us. Let us pray. Divine Presence, calling us to travel with trust, reminding us we are creatures of earth, breathing into us the breath of life, we open ourselves to the light of life. Bearer of the sun, draw us into the heart of your fire, that we may have light to uncover the unremembered stories and strength to endure their telling. Creator of the world, awaken to us the blessedness of the earth, that we may honour those who once dwelled along these paths that we now travel. Spirit who hovered over the face of the deep, lead us to life-giving waters, that we may give our tears to the depths and find refreshment and delight. Helper who breathes life into each generation, surround us with the winds of your spirit, that we may hear with tenderness the stories that they bear. And remembering Jesus, we pray together. God, you are life for us. Holy be your name. Your new day come, your will be done, on earth as in your vision. Give us this day our bread for the morrow, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Strengthen us in the time of test and deliver us from evil. For the power and the splendor and the fulfillment are yours, now and forever. Amen. At home or at church, we share words and gestures of peace. May the peace of divine presence be with you. Amen.
Listen for words of faith in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 4, verses 1 to 13. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit in the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. He ate nothing during those days, and when they were over, he was famished. The devil said to Jesus, "If you are God's own, command this stone to become a loaf of bread." Jesus answered, "It is written, one does not live by bread alone." Then the devil led him up and showed him in an instant all the nations of the world. And the devil said to him, "To you I will give their glory and all its authority, for it has been given over to me, and I give it to anyone I please. If you then will worship me, it will all be yours." Jesus answered him, "It is written, worship the Most High God. God alone you will serve." Then the devil led Jesus to Jerusalem and placed him on the pinnacle of the temple, saying to him, "If you are God's own, throw yourself down from here, for it is written, God will command the angels concerning you to protect you, and on their hands they will bear you up, so that you will not dash your foot against a stone." Jesus answered the devil, "It is said, do not put God to the test." When the devil had finished every test, Jesus was left alone. The devil awaited another opportunity. For the stories of Jesus, shaping faith and life, we give thanks. Thank you. contemporary reading is a poem by Jan Richardson. Beloved is where we begin. If you would enter into the wilderness, do not begin without a blessing. Do not leave without hearing who you are. Beloved, named by the one who has travelled this path before you. Do not let go without letting it echo in your ears. And if you find it is hard to let it into your heart, do not despair. That is what this journey is for. I cannot promise this blessing will free you from danger, from fear, from hunger or thirst, from the scorching of the sun or the fall of the night. But I can tell you that on this path there will be help. I can tell you that on this way there will be rest. I can tell you that you will know the strange graces that come to our aid only on a road such as this, that fly to meet us bearing comfort and strength, that come alongside us for no other cause than to lean themselves toward our ear and with their curious insistence whisper our name. Beloved, beloved, beloved. For the wilderness journey sustained by blessing, we give thanks.
Lent invites us to enter wilderness places of resistance and renewal in our lives for 40 days and 40 nights.
Baptized and blessed.
in the name of the Spirit, calling, challenging, and connecting us. This Wednesday just passed was Ash Wednesday, marking the beginning of Lent. With the construction happening next door to St Michael's and the deafening crashes that reverberate through the day, so that we now record these services in the evening, we were not going to start an Ash Wednesday tradition this year. So instead, I invite you to contemplate this image. In many churches, ash is made by burning the palm branches from Palm Sunday the previous year. The traditional words that are said as ash is used to make the sign of the cross on the forehead of congregation members are from Genesis chapter 3, verse 19. Remember, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. The traditional understanding that accompanies the imposition of ashes is that we are mortal, sinful, and nothing but dust. And so the season of Lent has been one of self-examination, self-denial, and penitence. Lent has been experienced as gloomy, heavy, and negative, focused on sacrifice, giving up nice things, rules, observances, abstentions, do-nots, have-nots, can-nots. But over the past 30 or so years, an alternative understanding has been explored and developed while maintaining traditional practices. Instead of seeing ourselves as worthless dust, we claim our connection to all that is, to all that has ever been. We are dust, yes, but the dust that we are is stardust. We reflect on our unity with all that is, remembering that each one of us is part of an immense and continuous creation, a creation that includes the entire universe. Although we humans are a vital part of this creation, we are by no means its centre. All too often we imagine and act as if we were the centre, as if everything were here for us to use for our own purposes, even to use up. Yet in our hearts, we know that we live in and through a complex set of relationships, and that it is our responsibility, as it has been the responsibility of the generations that preceded ours, to leave a healthy, fruitful, and beautiful world for all who shall follow. What does this understanding and connection and the sense of responsibility have to do with Lent? Perhaps if we are open to allowing the sacred to reveal the places in our hearts that suffer from the illusion that we are separate and apart from creation, if we are willing to allow the divine to bring into the light those places where we seek transformation in ourselves and in our world, this might enable us to understand and to practice Lent. The real work of Lent is to renew our sense of connection, so restoring our dignity and calling us back to ourselves, to a place where we acknowledge the invitation to choose life and our responsibility to act co-creatively with the sacred source of life and love. So beginning with Ash Wednesday, Lent invites us to come back to earth, to wonder at the gift of life, our own life, our life with the earth, the shared body of our existence. As ash is carbon, it reminds us of the carbon of the stars and our nature of stardust. Ash reorients us to our source in the divine and our purpose to live lives of compassion, justice, peace, and generosity. This is not just a romantic idea. Coming back to earth also connects us with the original intent of Lenten practice. We are mortal, and to the earth we will return. In March 2022, after 2 years of a global pandemic that has taken the lives of 6 million people worldwide, we have seen life, beautiful, unique human life, ended too soon, crumbling to dust and ashes. This week, as our siblings in the human family in Ukraine and Russia face the terrors and losses of war, the fears aroused by the threat of nuclear arms. We ask what it means that all of us, regardless of where we live or what political views we hold, all of us are small, mortal, vulnerable, and defenceless. It does not help us if we deny our mortality. We are stardust, and to stardust, and to the earth we will return. The gospel story tells of Jesus 40 days in the wilderness, full of the Holy Spirit and fresh from the waters of his baptism. Jesus is led by God's Spirit into the wilderness. Jesus, like shamans before and after him, must go on a vision quest in order to clarify his vocation and claim his future as God's beloved child. The devil in the story is not the central character, even though he plays the role of Jesus' tempter. Although we may not believe in a personal devil, as humans we know what it is to be tempted from the true path of our lives. The writer of Luke certainly did not imagine pitchforks, horns, pointy tails, a grotesque figure in a red onesie. It is more helpful to imagine instead a seductive voice offering very good things to Jesus, an attractive strategic plan for his ministry. The temptations are plausible, appealing, and they make a lot of sense in light of who Jesus heard God calling him to be. After all, why shouldn't Jesus satisfy his hunger with a little bread? And wouldn't it be great if Jesus, instead of the hated Romans, ruled the world? And how impressive would it be if Jesus flung himself off the temple roof and 1,000 angels came to rescue him? There is nothing inherently wrong with security, power, and comfort, the three temptations that Jesus faced, except when they alienate us from others and from the sacred vision for human and planetary life, from the divine passion calling us to creativity that will bring beauty and justice to the world and joy to our lives. Jesus' temptations teach us about priorities and power in this Lenten season. We don't often draw apart from the cacophony around us or the incessant electronics of our lives or the overload of messages and material objects, all of which seem to be set up as a smoke screen between us and the sacred. Well, sometimes there are smoke screen and sometimes there are wall, reinforced by our possessions, our place, our prestige, our security. In a way, the pandemic has been an opportunity to re-examine our priorities and reflect on where we place our trust, as well as what holds power in our lives. This Lent, far better than, say, giving up chocolate, we might develop a daily spiritual practice of reflection to reframe our lives. Last Sunday afternoon at St Michael's, together with the Interfaith Centre of Melbourne, we hosted an event for World Interfaith Harmony Week. It focused on spirituality and practice, grounded in the religious traditions of the faith leaders who presented. It was a beautiful time as we felt the joy of being able to gather together again with people of other faiths after the separation of the pandemic. I spoke about transfiguration and Lent and the contemplative practices of Lent as a journey inward and a journey outward, inward to the heart and outward to the world. Several of the faith leaders offered breathing meditation as a spiritual practice. Deep breaths. It sounds so simple. It is so simple. So often we fail to do this simple thing. This Lent, remember to breathe deeply. And while doing that, perhaps you could meditate on a mantra such as, I breathe in peace, I exhale worry. Another practice to consider is paying attention. Commit to noticing what's around you. We were so good at that during the lockdowns as we walked within our 5K radius, but it's easy to forget now that we are back in our familiar patterns. You can take as little as a minute to stop what you're doing and look. What do you see? What do you smell? What is one thing right in front of you now that you didn't notice before? Name it and give thanks to God or the universe, wherever you locate or name the sacred. Another practice might be reading centering poems. When we're bombarded with screens and media, it can be centering to step away from them. Instead, take time to savor a poem a day, or pick one or two poems to read again and again during Lent. Poems like the one that we heard today from Jan Richardson, "Beloved is where we begin." As we reflect on the ongoing pandemic and on what is happening in Ukraine, it seems to me that following Jesus in the wilderness, in doing that, Lent invites us to practice hope in the face of despair. Lent calls us to keep moving forward and saying together and saying to one another and saying to ourselves, we have to go through it. When we reach the final days of Lent, we are met not by what we've done or accomplished or how much chocolate we didn't eat, but by the cross and resurrection story, insisting on a hope that endures even in death. So this Lenten season, let's feel our feelings, engage with the story of Jesus' life and death, and find small, meaningful ways to honour the season, going through it, whatever it may be, together. Remember that you are stardust, and to stardust you shall return. Let the knowledge of your humanity awaken you to the wonders, joys, sorrows, and pain of life. Let it be said of you that here in this little part of the cosmos, in small and simple ways, that you lived fully, loved extravagantly, and helped humanity become all that the divine dreamed that we can be. Amen. Giving and receiving blessing, we sing together, "For You, Deep Stillness." the prayers of the people in thanksgiving and solidarity. Let us pray. We give thanks for the riches of our tradition, for the legacies and stories of those who travelled this road before us, who point to ways in which we can find strength when facing troubles, and wisdom when faced with dilemmas that are difficult to resolve. We are thankful for the Spirit dwelling amongst us, sustaining our hope that good will overcome evil, insisting that we trust that the kingdom will come. We are grateful for the many ways we encounter the divine, that they happen unexpectedly and often at the time we need them most. In this time of war, we pray for peace between Russia and Ukraine. Our hearts break for the injured, the grieving, for men who have been conscripted to fight from both countries, and for Ukrainian women, children, and older men forced to flee Ukraine as refugees. We pray for global political leaders and diplomats, people who are working hard to avert the horror of nuclear war. May we be open to all who need our help and support at this time, carried across boundaries of nation, faith, and culture, so that we can recognize suffering beyond those close to us. We pray for First Nations people of this land and all around the world, and for all who work alongside them to bring justice and reconciliation. We pray that we may have a passion to understand the deep knowledge and wisdom of First Peoples. May we look around and see the longings present in our own community, aware of our anxieties or weariness, as we try to stay true to the way of Jesus. And in a time of silence, we name people or places whose needs we know, as we listen to the Spirit calling us to respond with courage and compassion. Be with us in each moment, Divine Presence, giving us strength and courage and love in all we do. Amen. St. Michael's community is sustained by gifts of time, money and skills, generously given by members and friends. During the pandemic, offerings have been given in non-contact ways. But in the prayer, we give thanks for gifts given in church, via the website or by post, to support the life and work of St. Michael's, including these video services and the Mingaree Kenmiller Counselling Service. Dedicating all the gifts shared in different ways, let us pray together. Compassionate God, who calls all people to be one family, may we share generously the gifts we have been given. May we be strengthened to make peace by working together, and challenged with a vision of the feast where all are welcome. Amen. The Spirit that called Jesus is calling still. Let us sing together, Spirit of Gentleness. a blessing for Lent. Travel gently on the journey. Know that the Holy One who holds all things will be there, that Christ who calls us friend will walk beside us, and the Spirit who makes all things new will lead us with light and hope. Amen.